Easter. I hope you're having a nice holiday. Things have been kind of crazy around the Noferblatt's house for the past month. You may recall I mentioned earlier that my daughter had bought a foreclosure. Well, since they closed on the house, we have been over there every Saturday helping them work on the house. When you buy a foreclosure, it's a lot of work or a lot of money hiring other people to do the work. Take your pick. They don't have the money, so it's a lot of work. Anyway, if you also are subscribed to Noferblatt's channel, you may have noticed he didn't have a video last week. Cut him a little slack. He's been really busting his butt working at our daughter's, so hopefully he'll have one up this week. He's been doing the majority of the work over there, between the two of us, mind you. My son-in-law has really been doing a lot of the work. But he's, you know, a former electrician, and a lot of what needed to be done was electrical. It's a skill set that not the average Joe has. So from, you know, mapping out all the circuits in the panel, to repairing some problems with the panel, to doing some outside electrical work and a lot of interior electrical work, even little things like replacing outlets. Eventually my daughter wants all the switches and the outlets replaced. She wants to go with white. What they had before was the ivory beige color ones, which was bad enough, but they've got paint all over them and some are cracked. I mean, the house is in rough shape. It's a foreclosure. So since that's real expensive to buy all of the switches and all the outlets that she needs for this, you know, huge, nearly 3,000 square foot house, she was going to just do it one room at a time. But just replacing the receptacles, the outlets, has been a pain because of the way they were wired. Maybe it's just the way things were done back then versus the way they're done now, but Noferblatt has been having to do a lot of extra work replacing outlets as he does them. And then on top of that, there's a lot that are basically broken. The outlet itself isn't broken, but there's a thing called a plaster ring that sits on front of the box that actually holds the wiring and the outlet itself. This plaster ring has two holes, top and bottom, that little screws affix the outlet to the plaster ring, holding it good and steady. And then your cover plate goes on top of that, and it screws in usually in the middle. All fine and good, except that the plaster rings in several of the cases are plastic and they've broken. So where the screw was supposed to be holding the outlet in place, the receptacle in place, with the plastic broken around where the screw goes in, there's nothing to hold it. So you've got outlets that are all wonky. You know, they're sticking out into the room. You've got all this wire pushing against the outlet, making it come out. And when you've got a toddler in the house, that's just not safe. So there's been a lot of that kind of work. And unfortunately, in order to replace that plaster ring, you have to remove part of the drywall. It's not a simple process. Not, you know, not like replacing a cover plate. So he's had to cut out the drywall around several outlets already, and I know there's going to be a lot more that need to be done. So we're looking at still many more trips over there to help the kids get this house safe. and I mean, it's eventually the kids are going to have a lot of work. I mean, the kitchen at some point needs to be remodeled. Bathrooms need to be redone. A ton of work is needed to go into this house. You can get a great deal with a foreclosure, and they did. They bought a house in a really nice neighborhood, and it was at one time, I'm sure, a nice house, but because it fell into foreclosure, it was in rough shape, so they got it for a really good price. Someday down the road, when a lot of work's been done on it, it'll be worth a lot of money for them, and it'll have been a good deal, but it's kind of hard to live with right now. So that's what's been monopolizing a good chunk of our free time for the last month. And like I said, Noferblatt has been bearing the brunt of that. Yeah, he gets kind of frustrated doing remodeling work anyway. It's not what he wanted to do with his life. But it's hard enough when you're doing it in your own home where all of your tools are there. But when you're going to someone else's house to do it, you have to think ahead of time, okay, what do I need to bring? Pack all of those tools up, load them into the truck, drive over there, unpack all of those tools, do the work, pack them all up again, load them into the truck, come back home and unload them and put them all away, only to do it again the next weekend. So it's been a little frustrating for him. He's a great guy. He knows that it needs to be done, and the kids aren't in any position to hire it out, so. And he'll like to tease me and say, I owe him big time for all of this. Anyway, that's why you may not have seen a video from him last week. Hopefully he will get one this week. I'm going to start talking about our bathroom remodel we did. I kind of teased it at the end of the kitchen remodel. When I bought this house, I hated the kitchen. I told you that when I was doing the videos about the kitchen. I hated it. I also hated this bathroom. It was ugly. It's small, nothing I can do about that, but it was so ugly. You'll see. I'm going to show you pictures. Don't take my word for it. But the tub was this pastel aqua color that fits with the time period of this house's construction. This house was built in 1959. But it doesn't match anything else in the bathroom. The wall tiles were the field tiles, in other words, the main tiles on the wall, were white with these little gray speckles, and then that was trimmed with this gray bullnose tile. Doesn't really go with an aqua colored bathtub. And the vanity was way too big. It was a 48 inch wide vanity that nearly touches the tank on the toilet. I'm going to show you a picture so you can see what I'm talking about. Way too big. I understand it's a small bathroom, you're probably trying to maximize the storage, but no, don't do that. We could tell this bathroom had obviously been remodeled at least once because, like I said, the tub looks like it was original to the house, but it doesn't match anything else in the bathroom. On top of that, the vanity was obviously done at some point after this wall tile was done. And I say that, and you're going to see a photo of what I mean. At some point after the wall tile went up, someone had done these like little decals, for lack of a better word, on a couple of the backsplash tiles that are now half obscured by the vanity, or at the time of starting this remodel, were half obscured by the vanity. So little things like that. So the vanity obviously came in much later. It probably came in right before we bought this house. I'm guessing that we knew that the man who owned this house before us used this house as a rental for many years. He bought it, I think, back in the 70s and had been using it for a rental all this time. And it sat empty for, I think, a year and a half before we bought it. He had to do a bunch of work. There was a subsidence issue that he had to handle on the house. And then he did various and sundry other things probably to get it ready for selling instead of renting. He replaced almost all the windows in the house, and I suspect that's when that vanity went in, because it was a fairly modern looking vanity. But it was still ugly. Oh, ugly, 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 ugly. We blew all of our savings on the kitchen remodel. So it's not like I had a bunch of money laying around to hire someone to redo that bathroom. And we were so tired of remodeling after doing the kitchen, I knew I was going to have a hard sell getting Neferblatt to agree to do it. So I had a bright idea. I was going to do just a minimal renovation of the bathroom. Just a little bit. I was going to replace the vanity. I was going to remove part of the wall tile. The bathroom had wall tile on all four walls. And that doesn't need to be there. And it creates problems when you want to put up things like towel bars and toilet paper holders and things like that. So I wanted to remove everything except the tile around the three sides of the tub and again and extending to behind the toilet, and then that was it. The rest was going to come out. I was going to use bamboo flooring to do wainscoting, horizontal bamboo on the walls for wainscoting, paint, and you know, that was about it. I was going to have a company come in and refinish the tub and what was remaining of the wall tile, just have them sprayed white so that they would match at least and not look so ugly. Well, I told Neferblatt's my bright idea, and he proceeded to punch all kinds of holes in it, which that's okay, they needed to be done. He's like, well, what about this? Well, what about this? Well, what about this? We did a little test of surgically removing some of those wall tiles, and we found that that wasn't going to be viable, which is just as well, because I'd gotten quotes from companies who would do the refinishing of the wall tile in the tub. Expensive? Oh my word. I had originally planned on saving, you know, the tub to save money. It was going to cost me as much to refinish it as it would be to buy a new tub. And since that old tub was only 14 inches tall from the bathroom floor to the top of the side of the tub, so the interior dimension was even less. It was worthless, so I was going to have to get rid of the tub too. I saved money other ways. For my business, what I do with my company that I run, I do graphic design, typesetting, and websites. I build websites for people. I had the bright idea I could barter web work with people for a vanity, I wanted a vessel sink for a countertop, things like that. I found one fellow who actually was a full general contractor, someone who actually built houses. He was selling vanities, among other things, online, but not through his own website. And I contacted him and I said, how about this? I need a vanity for my bathroom, but I need it custom made because 48 inches, vanities come in standard widths, and 48 inches was too big, and the next width down is typically 36, and that would have been really too small. I needed to maximize storage in this bathroom. So I wanted a custom built vanity. We, Nofer Blatz and I talked about building it ourselves. I was nervous about that because I wanted a lot of drawers, and that's something we haven't done. Building like bookcases, not so bad. Building something with drawers, a little more tricky. So this guy agreed to custom build my vanity to my specs in exchange for building him a website for his business. And since the vanity itself wouldn't be as much as building the website would be, he threw in my vessel sink and all my plumbing, all my fixtures, my faucet for the sink and my tub and shower, faucet and shower head, all that kind of stuff. Great. Then I just needed a countertop. And I found another guy who did bathroom and kitchen remodels who agreed to, he had a website, but it wasn't very good. So we agreed that I would remodel his website, basically rebuild his website, and he would throw in my kitchen countertop. In fact, I was originally going to get flooring for my living room from him too. That one didn't pan out. Barter deals sometimes are great, sometimes they don't work out too well. But I did get my nice granite countertop, so I was happy. Anyway, I managed to pull this off relatively inexpensively by shaving corners everywhere I could. My porcelain tile that I used for the floor and the wall, got a really great deal on it. Unfortunately, it wasn't rectified, and that just means it wasn't, every tile wasn't the exact same size. There'd be slight variations. It might be slightly out of square, which makes installation a little more problematic, but that's okay. I saved a lot of money on this, on the tiles. And we just hired out the plumbing as we did in the kitchen. The same guy did the plumbing for the bathroom, and he sold us our toilet and new tub. So this video, I'm just going to, besides introducing it, I'm going to show you photos of what the bathroom looked like prior to doing anything to it. And you'll see why it was so desperately in need of remodeling. Next week, I'll talk about the demo phase. After that, we'll do the construction, rebuilding everything, and then finish. So here are photos of what this horrible bathroom looked like before we did anything to it. Check it out. So here's the bathroom the way it used to look. Actually, this is after we'd done a little bit of the work already. We'd removed the ugly, horrible, fake parquet vinyl floor. You can see the remnants, the little crisscross pattern on the floor from those old vinyl tiles. And we'd removed the shower doors from the side of the tub. Here's that tub. Is that not ugly? And as you can see, it doesn't go with the white and gray tiles on the wall. Now here's the 48 inch vanity. You see the pieces of decorative tiles that stick up above the back of the little built-in backsplash on the vanity. That's how I could tell this was definitely put in after the fact at some point in time. And if you look in the reflection in the mirror, you can see the old shower doors we'd removed and miscellaneous supplies. And this is a little better view, so you can see just how close the vanity comes to that toilet. What were they thinking? And like I said, trying to affix towel bars to a tile wall can be precarious. As you can see, this one's being held on by just a prayer, really. All that gunk, that's a lot of excess caulk and debris caught in the caulk. You never could get it to look clean. It was very frustrating. So you agree with me? Is it not an ugly bathroom? Was, at least. It looks way better now. But you'll have to wait to see what it looks like today. That's all for now. See you next week.
See ya.